Welcome to my channel Lenovate. Today we will going to discuss this session number 9 on MCAT biology. Previously we have discussed all chapters from chapter number 1 till the chapter number 8 on MCAT biology, and in this video we are going to discuss the chapter number 9 that is taken from the first year biology, that is the kingdom plantae. So the MCQs related to kingdom plantae are little more, but it is very important chapter. That's why I extended the MCQs, and I will going to share you with the important MCQs, and also we will going to discuss the answer key with you. So all of the MCQs are taken from the important notes and from the past papers and from your textbooks. So keep watching and subscribe our channel for more videos. Okay, starting from the chapter number 1, question number 1 of the chapter number 9 of MCAT biology. Question number 1 says the non-vascular plants are A. Trachophytes, B. Lycopsid, C. Bryophyte, and D. Gymnosperm. Which of the following is a non-vascular plant? Means it does not have a vascular supply. So the major class that is considered as a non-vascular plant is bryophyte, that is C. Option number C for question number 1 is correct. Question number 2 is also regarding to the bryophyte. 2 says bryophytes can sprawl horizontally or reach their small height because why they can sprawl horizontally or they can change their height? What is the reason behind that? They are asking that. A. They lack the lignin. B. They are amorphous. Or C. They have flagella. So it is somewhat logical question that if the plant lacks lignin, it will going to change its shape. It will not going to stick at one side. So option number A for question number 2 is correct, that is they lack the lignin. Question number 3 says sporophytes of Fanaria produce A. Simple pores, B. Sporangiophores, C. Haploid spore. Which of the following will be produced by the sporophytes of the Fanaria? So the answer for this question is C, that is haploid spore. Means single spore is produced by the sporophytes of Fanaria, that is a class of kingdom plantae. Question number 4 says, which of the following is an adaptive characteristic exhibited by land invading plant? A. Conservation of water, B. Heterogamy, C. Formation of embryos, and D. All of them. So if you know the characteristic of a land plant, you will get to know that these all the characteristics are present in the land invading plant. So the land invading plant, we get the example from the trachophyte having all the characteristics. So you will get to going to take the option number D, that is all of them is correct for the land invading plant. Okay, question number 5 says filament is a part of A. sepal, B. petal, C. stamen, and D. leaf. Filament is a part of which of the following part of flower? Which of the following part of flower is having a filament in it? So the option for this question is C, that is correct, that is stamen having a filament as a part, while the sepals and petals and leaves are the separate part of a complete flower. You have to learn this all the important points and all the important classes of the kingdom plantae. Question number 6 says Fanaria is A. Moss, B. Liverwort, C. Lycopsid. Fanaria is an example of a moss. So the option number A for the question number 6 is correct. Okay, now the question number 7 says especially reproducible or reproductible leaves of the Schlesinella are called A. Sporangia, B. Sporophore, C. Sporophylls. These all are the, you can say these are all identical names, so you have to correct our best option from this MCQ, and the answer for this MCQ is the sporophylls. You can learn it by Schlesinella having the two L's and sporophylls also having the two L's. It is a mnemonic to learn easily. Okay, coming to the next questions, it says trachophytes are A. land plant, B. amphibious plant, and C. water plants. Either they are land plants, either they are both of them, or either they are water plants. So we have just discussed previously in the previous questions that the water plants are mostly the bryophytes. So if you know the examples of tracheophytes and you have learned the chapter, you get to know that the tracheophytes are the land plants and they are considered to be as a land plant, and they exhibit all the characteristics of the land plant that we have discussed in the previous MCQ. So option number A for question number 8 is correct. Now the next question says, welcome to my channel Lanavate. In this part of video, we will going to discuss further on questions on the chapter number 9 of first year biology, that is kingdom plant. So we will going to start from the question number 9 that we have left. Okay, so question number 9 says, which of the following is not a group of conimospum? Which of the following is not included in conimospum? Number 1, pteridospum. Number 2, gynkago. Number 3, crucifera. And number 4 is conifera. So the option for question number 9 is C. The crucifera is not a group of conimospum. That is not an example of conisperm. So the option number C for question number 9 is correct. Moving towards question number 10, they are asking the group of tracheophyte having neither roots nor leaves. Which of the following group have no roots and no leaves in the tracheophyte? A. Coleopsida. B. Sphenopsida. C. Lycopsida. And D. Pteropsida. So, the group that does not contain the root and the leaf is Coleopsida. This Coleopsida group of tracheophyte does not contain the leaves and the roots at all. Question number 11 says, fern is a dash a non-seeded vascular plant, B. Seeded vascular plant, C. A non-seeded avascular plant. So, if you know the example of fern and if you have read the characteristic of fern, you will get to know that it is a vascular plant and it is a non-seeded vascular plant. So, the option number A for question number 11 is correct. Question number 12 says, seed form belongs to which of the following contain the seed form? A. Pteropsida. B. Spermopsida. C. Musky. And D. Lycopsida. Question number 12 has the correct option, Spermopsida. This is the seed form that belongs to the Spermopsida. Question number 13 says, which of the following is mismatched? The given below, all the options are correctly matched. You have to identify which of the following is mismatched. So, A. Musky, example mosses. B. Lycopsida, example Lycopsidum. C. Sphenopsida, example Phlegenilla. D. Anthrocerotic, example Anthrocerotes. So if we get to know the examples, we will easily identify that the option number C, Sphenopsida with the Phlegenilla, is inappropriate. So answer for the question number 13 is option number C. Question number 14 says, in the pinus plant, in the pinus female, the gametophyte develop from A. Meiosis, B. Repeated mitosis, C. Heterospory, and D. All of them. Which of the following is a mode of division of megaspore formation in the female gametophyte of pinus? So the answer for this question is B. There is a repeated mitosis division take place in the female gametophyte of pinus. Now coming to the next question, question number 15. The taxonomic family in which the ovary is obliquely placed. A. Rosaceae. B. Solanaceae. C. Poaceae. Which of the following taxonomic name of family in which ovary is obliquely placed? So the answer for the question number 15 is correct is B. Solanaceae, having an ovary obliquely placed. Question number 16 says, in angiosperm, embryonic sac nuclei give rise to A. 4 haploid nuclei. B. 8 haploid nuclei. And C. 4 diploid nuclei. So the angiosperm, if you have learned the angiosperm, you will get to know that the embryo of angiosperm contain 8 haploid nuclei. So option number B for question number 16 is correct. Question number 17 says, the generative cell of pollen grain give rise to A. Microsporangium. B. Sperm. C. Disintegrate. And D. Spore. Which is the male part of the pollen grain that is formed from the generative cell of the plant? So this is the sperm that is produced. So option number B for question number 17 is correct. Question number 18 says, the botanical name of tomato is A. Solium melongena. B. Atropa belladonna. C. Cisbania aegypta. And D. Lysopyrcium esculentum. These are the botanical names given, but they are asking which of the following is the botanical name for the tomato. So you have to learn the important botanical name of the important fruits and vegetables. So the botanical name for tomato is Lycopersicum scultum. So the option number D for question number 18 is correct. Question number 19 says, all the pulses belongs to A. Family Mimosae, B. Family Solaceae, C. Family Papilaceae, and D. Family Rosaceae. So the pulses, as the name suggests, they are pulses. So say they will be belonging to the Papilaceae. There is some mnemonic to remember the pulses for P, and Papilaceae is also from P. So answer number C, option number C is correct for the question number 19. This is somewhat trick to learn this question. Now the last one, but not the least one, because the kingdom plantae is an important chapter to learn for the MCAT examination, also for the intermediate. So you have to prepare well from this chapter. If you have any query, comment below, ask me and I will upload this or more videos. Keep following, keep subscribing. Question number 20 says, which of the following is the botanical name for apple? Here they are asking the botanical name of apple. A. Malva sylvestris, B. Malva persica, C. Malva arensis, and D. Datura alba. So the answer for question number 20 is A. Malva sylvestris is the botanical name of apple. And you have to remember this name as we have remembered the name of tomato. So this was all. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more and keep loving us, sharing us and supporting us. Thank you.